This is the final episode of Hey Arnold, the series finale for a show that millions of people connected with over the course of 8 years and 5 seasons. If that sounds like an extraordinary amount of time for 5 seasons of an animated show to air, it kind of was. But this moment was a culmination of all the work, the care, the love that its creators and crew put into it. You might not have seen it, though. Why? Because 8 years after the show's premiere, Nickelodeon aired this episode, totally unannounced, in a seemingly random time slot, with no acknowledgement, no fanfare, not a word. You turned on your TV, and if you happened to catch it, great. If not, oh well. The story of Hey Arnold is a story about what made it great, and a story about what goes wrong behind the scenes at large networks, of what happens when suits and ties make decisions for creators. It started here. This is Arnold Escapes from Church, a claymation short film created in 1988 by Craig Bartlett, who at the time was working on this. Yeah, that's Pee-wee's Playhouse. Eventually, he would show these shorts that were intended to focus on Penny here, yeah, you might recognize her, to Nickelodeon after many failed pitch attempts for other ideas. Nick loved it, but they didn't love Penny. They loved Arnold. And so a show about him was greenlit. The show would revolve around Arnold and his friends navigating what was essentially the real world. The pilot, this thing right here, was created by Craig Bartlett in his living room, and from there, Hey Arnold was born.
Move it, football head!
Hey Arnold!
Arnold was a special show. It was a genuine attempt to connect with an audience of people that saw animation as a reflection of their everyday lives. Arnold was a regular, awkward kid. As Bartlett put it, a kid who was constantly faced with responsibility and problems that he solved reluctantly. He didn't ask for them, he isn't a hero, he's just, well, a kid. And the show navigated that balance superbly by writing characters and situations that were genuinely relatable. Helga's parents were depicted as drunks, dysfunctional, and in some ways overbearing, and in equally as many ways disappointed with Helga in the shadow of her much more traditionally successful older sister. Raise your hand if you connect with any of that. Phoebe's one-sided friendship with Helga created tension, problems between the two, a dynamic link to real adolescence, and in turn, it became clear that the show was not going to be shy about its intentions, to show its audience both sides of youth and adulthood. Yeah, sure, Pigeon Man was a little absurd, but even examples like this strange myth of a man running around the city, was layered and peeled to reveal something surprisingly human. Arnold was really at its core a very slice-of-life-esque piece of Western animation. It didn't thrive on plot or serialization or even ideas. It was almost exclusively built on character and relationships. And that was unique for this era of animation on Nick and laid the groundwork for shows like Ginger. A great example of this is the episode Arnold's Christmas.
Yes, this type of year always make me remember.
Remember what?
It was a long time ago, Arnold.
Arnold's Christmas makes the demise of the show all that more sad. In Arnold's Christmas, everything great about the show converges into one bite-sized piece of television. The smooth jazz music that introduced millions of kids to that genre of music. Yeah, that's on full display here. The pseudo New York City that's painted as a playground for youth. Yep, here in all of its incredible holiday glory. But it's this guy that proves just how much faith Bartlett and his team had in their audience. In Arnold's Christmas, we learn that Mr.Wynn was a Vietnamese immigrant that migrated to America after the very real fall of Saigon. But at the time, he had to choose the safety of himself or his daughter. Who would be free? He chose her. Wynn has been living with that decision for decades, having let go of his daughter with no way to reach her. He's become a single father without his family. This was a portraiture of depression, of sadness, of regret in some ways. And the episode's depiction of the Vietnamese War in what was essentially a kid show and the impact that has on immigrants still struggling as a result was powerful. But having our hero Arnold be heroic by bringing this immigrant family back together is one of the more powerful messages you'll ever see in animation. A very grounded reminder to care for everyone, to judge no one, and to appreciate others and their stories because you never know how much worse they have it than you, despite the smiling face you see in front of you. And yet, Nick, the network, well, they weren't quite as moved.
Here you go, Arnold. Tell your friend I'm sorry they aren't mashed, but he probably wants to do that himself.
Near the end of the third season, Nickelodeon approached Bartlett with an opportunity. He would develop two Hey Arnold movies, one for TV and the second for theaters. So he began development, creating an easier-to-digest TV movie called Hey Arnold the Movie, and then writing a much more complex and lengthier theatrical film that required a dramatically different amount of effort. But Nickelodeon, well, they got a little anxious. Wanting to capitalize financially on their newfound theatrical train, Nick forced the first made-for-TV movie into theaters, a film not created for that format, a film not treated the same way as the much more refined second movie that was in development. But Nick didn't care. And it showed. Hey Arnold the movie was rushed out the door and into the box office race as fast as possible, and it failed equally as fast. In fact, it was such a critical and financial failure that Nick gave up on Arnold entirely. The fifth season, having been completed, suffered. Nick would release the final season's 20 episodes over the course of the next 4 years. That's an average of 5 episodes a year, randomly dropping new episodes unceremoniously whenever they needed a time slot fit. In the interim, they would also cancel Hey Arnold the Jungle Movie. You know, the movie Bartlett poured his heart and soul into, thinking it would be his theatrical debut. The movie would release over a decade later in an altered form. And finally, one day, that last episode of Hey Arnold would randomly hit air. No announcement, no appreciation for one of the network's best shows, just there and gone, burying Arnold for good. All of this as a result of one greedy, hasty decision. It's not really a coincidence that it was around this time that you could pinpoint the start of the end of an era for Nickelodeon, a golden era. As networks began to realize the potential of the larger media market, shows like Hey Arnold, without big ideas and marketable movie franchises, were left to burn. But in a strangely romantic way, I think that may encapsulate Hey Arnold better than anything else. A show that was as much about fun and youthfulness as it was about reality, disappointment, and just doing your best through it all. Yeah, Hey Arnold was given the short end of an unfortunately harsh stick, but here it is, decades later, still kicking, with excellent music and an absurdly cool vibe in Hey Arnold the Jungle Movie. I guess the point is that good art, great stories, survive no matter what. So, who cares if what you make gets no views? Who cares if somebody or a platform buries what you're doing, or your art isn't selling right away, or your script isn't being optioned? Keep drawing. Creating, writing, trust that if this football head can survive over a decade later, well, your stuff probably will too. Today's video was sponsored by Audible, by the way. You can start listening with a 30-day free Audible trial. You can choose one audiobook and two Audible originals absolutely free if you visit audible.com/nerdstalgic or text nerdstalgic to 500-500. I love Audible, especially during this time. There's so much going on. I'm working from home, and it's nice to be able to just listen to the books I want to read, and usually books that I want to read for research, so I can, you know, make the videos you see on this channel. I'm reading all the time for this channel, making sure that I know what I want to talk about and understand the things I want to talk about. For this particular video, I actually listened to the book Slimed by Matthew Klickstein. It's basically an oral history of Nickelodeon's golden age. You can actually listen to it right now if you sign up for that free trial we were talking about. It just helped a lot, set the tone for this piece, and it kind of gave me a little bit of background on this era of Nickelodeon. Audible just is an incredible way to consume, well, literature. Again, you can start listening today with a 30-day Audible trial. Choose one audiobook, two Audible originals, absolutely free if you visit audible.com/nerdstalgic or text nerdstalgic to 500-500. It's a huge help to the channel, and it's free, so, you know, huge help to you guys too. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, press the like button down below. If you have yet done so, also hit subscribe, and on your screen right now are all of the great patrons from this month, all of the amazing people supporting Nerdstalgic, and also two more videos from the channel, so you can stick around and see, you know, what else I've done recently. So hopefully I'll see you guys in the next video. Oh, and by the way, there's a huge announcement coming next week that I'm really excited about.